Welcome to another example of graphing a piecewise defined function. Looking at our piecewise function, notice how we have three function rules, so graphically we can expect three pieces. F of x equals negative x minus 1 if x is greater than or equal to negative 3 and less than 1, and f of x equals negative 1 if x is greater than or equal to 1 and less than 3. Notice f of x equals 4 and f of x equals negative 1 are both constant functions, or functions in the form of f of x equals a constant c, or if we want y equals c, which means the graphs of these will be pieces of horizontal lines. And then f of x equals negative x minus 1 is a linear function in slope-intercept form, or the form f of x equals mx plus b, where b is the y-intercept of the line and m is the slope of the line, which means this piece will be a piece of a slanted line. Normally what I prefer to do is graph the entire function and then determine what piece of the graph we want based upon the interval for x. So we'll start by graphing f of x equals 4, which would be a horizontal line passing through 4 on the y-axis. So it would look something like this. But we only want the piece of this line when x is less than negative 3. So we'll find negative 3 on this line, which should be right here. Notice negative 3 is not in this interval, so we make an open point on negative 3, and x is less than negative 3 to the left, so we only want the blue piece of this horizontal line, which means we need to erase the rest of the line. This graph here is the graph of f of x equals 4 if x is less than negative 3. The next function rule, f of x equals negative x minus 1, will be the graph of a line where the slope is equal to negative 1 or negative 1 over 1, and the y-intercept or b is equal to negative 1. Again, we'll graph this entire line and then determine what piece is in the given interval. So we'll plot the y-intercept of negative 1, should be here. The slope is negative 1 over 1, which means we'll go down 1 and right 1, down 1 and right 1, down 1 and right 1, and so on. Our linear function will pass through these four points and look something like this. But we only want the piece of the line when x is greater than or equal to negative 3 and less than 1. So we'll find where x equals negative 3 on the line is this point here. Negative 3 is in the interval this time, so we'll make a closed point here. And then we'll start approaching positive 1, but notice how positive 1 is not in this interval, so we'll have an open point when x equals positive 1. So we'll make an open point here. We only want the blue piece of this line, so we erase the rest of the line. And then for the last piece, we have f of x equals negative 1, which will be a horizontal line passing through negative 1 on the y-axis. So it'll look something like this. But we only want the piece when x is greater than or equal to 1 and less than 3. 1 is in this interval, so on this line when x equals 1, we have a closed point. We'll approach positive 3, but 3 is not in the interval, so we'll have an open point on 3. And now we need to erase the rest of the horizontal line, leaving only the blue piece. So this would be the graph of our piecewise defined function. This piece corresponds to the blue function rule. This piece corresponds to the green function rule. And this piece corresponds to the yellow function rule. I hope you found this helpful.